There is no question women have a lot of new information to digest this week. First, those new recommendations about mammograms, encouraging women to start later and have fewer of them. Now, new guidelines on pap tests, an effective tool for detecting cervical cancer. News Channel 5's Anya Haneke has story number two tonight.
Hi, Snuggles.
This month, Allison Hicks reached a milestone.
Girl.
She's cancer-free 5 years after her diagnosis.
It was so shocking for me. I was unaware of HPV. I'd never heard about any before.
Come on, Penny.
At the age of 29, Hicks of Winooski, Vermont, found out she had cervical cancer, which is most often caused by the human papillomavirus. She says everything changed after that.
Once you're diagnosed with the cancer, all the treatment starting afterwards is life-changing.
She's happy that's behind her. Now she tries to help other women avoid the same experience. Her two words of advice.
Pay attention.
New guidelines this week from the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists, though, seem to suggest that less attention may in fact be better when it comes to screening for cervical cancer. The organization has raised its recommended age for a first pap smear to 21. It recommends screening every other year instead of every year up to age 30, and then every 3 years after that in healthy women.
The whole evolution of pap smear screening is going in this direction.
Dr. Roger Young, director of the colposcopy clinic at Fletcher Allen Healthcare, says the trend in recent years has been to perform fewer pap smears on women.
And I basically took a section of this patient's cervix out.
The intent, he says, is to produce fewer false positives and perform fewer unnecessary procedures, which can be harmful to women.
So it's extremely important to do this when it's appropriate, but not do it when it's not appropriate.
The announcement comes on the heels of other recommendations for women to reduce the number of mammograms they receive to screen for breast cancer.
A lot of information to take in.
Contrary to its position on the new mammography guidelines, the American Cancer Society generally agrees with the new recommendations for pap smears, saying there's little benefit to women in annual screening.
I think the key point is just making sure that women have access to screenings.
According to the American Cancer Society, most women who die from cervical cancer have never been screened or have not been screened in at least 5 years. That's what needs to change most, Allison Hicks believes.
It's so preventable.
So that other women can steer clear of this cancer. In Burlington, Anya Haneke, News Channel 5.